Welcome to Pfeiffer Vacuum. My name is Jan-Hendrik Biller. In this new video series, we want to give you a good guidance through the basics of vacuum. Nowadays, it is impossible to imagine everyday life without vacuum. Vacuum is required for almost all products during their development and production process. Whether in the manufacture of semiconductor chips, basic research, medical technology, or for example, the coating of food packaging. The standard definition of vacuum is the state of a gas at which its pressure in a vessel and therefore its particle density is lower than that of the ambient surrounding atmosphere, or in which the pressure of the gas is lower than 300 hectopascal. That means lower than the pressure on the atmosphere on Earth's surface. Both atmospheric pressure and particle density decrease with increasing altitude. We'll look at the exact meaning of these two terms in one of our next videos. The decrease of the atmospheric pressure with increasing altitude results in different pressure ranges in the closer environment of our planet. These ranges can be explained well with the help of this graphic. The atmospheric pressure usually found on Earth is about 1000 hectopascal, but it always depends on several factors such as weather or your location. Here we speak of rough or low vacuum. At the cruising altitude of a commercial aircraft, the pressure has already dropped to about 290 hectopascal. The International Space Station ISS moves in an orbit at an altitude of about 400 kilometers. The pressure existing there is already in the high vacuum range. The lowest known pressures are found in the interstellar space of the universe. Here we speak of extremely high vacuum. The prevailing pressure is below 1 to the power of minus 11 hectopascal. By the way, an ideal vacuum of 0 hectopascal, that means a space without matter, does not exist yet. In the next video, we will look at more precise definition of pressure. Stay tuned!